The following contest is a 2 out of 3 falls match and is for the WWE Championship.
Six foot 4, 350 pounds of rage. Time Intercontinental Champion here in WWE, a truly terrifying blend of size, speed, and aggression.
And think about all the epic brawls we've seen Umaga involved in against the likes of both John Cena and Bobby Lashley.
The game has arrived. The Cerebral Assassin ready to engage in warfare.
This is gonna be good.
Over the last decade, we have seen this man's dominance grow from a blue blood to a degenerate to a multiple-time WWE champion.
Indeed, Triple H has solidified himself at the top of the food chain in WWE, and he has no plans on stepping down anytime soon.
And I don't think anyone can take him down.
From D-Generation X to Evolution, we have seen Triple H amass power in WWE, cultivating strength in numbers.
But there's no more room under the learning tree of the Cerebral Assassin. Now he's all about earning the gold and glory for himself.
Indeed, the game has never been more dangerous.
Introducing the challenger from the Isle of Samoa, weighing in at 350 pounds, the Samoan Bulldozer, Umaga! And his opponent from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing in at 255 pounds, he is the WWE Champion! Triple H!
Looking at the champion, I guarantee there is no doubt in their mind as to who is leaving this match with the title around their waist.
It's the structure that's going to make the difference in this one, folks. These superstars can act all nonchalant all they want, but when you see that structure and the door slams behind you, I don't care who you are, you shudder inside.
No argument there, Corey. That's why there have been so few WWE superstars.
A bear hug,
crouched in. Gotta find a way out and catch your breath.
Look at this. No quit whatsoever. Raining down elbows and escaping the bear hug.
That unraveled on Umaga. Draped across the top rope. Clubbing forearm.
Punch to the stomach and stopped in their tracks. Clothesline.
The Cerebral Assassin showing how he earned the name, working his way into an opponent's head. Enabled to counter.
Sit out powerbomb. A powerbomb like that will leave you with bruises and remind you of this moment for days.
And now this is the right move. Get out of Dodge and collect yourself.
He returns to the ring.
Samoan drop.
Out of the ring and even closer to the chain link enclosure.
He's got his hands on a sledgehammer. Total chaos is about to be unleashed.
You'd have to think that in a submission match, the advantage goes to the most technically skilled competitor.
9 times out of 10, I'd say that's right. But every now and then, I think sheer willpower can actually upset in-ring know-how. All the holds and counters in the world won't help you much if your opponent simply refuses to give in and give up.
Compromised position here.
Piercing the throat.
Look at this. He just tossed the leg.
Just a perfect mix of pure power.
Bear hug squeezing the breath out of it. This is the
furiously trying to fight his way out of the bear hug. Can he do it? Yes.
Talk about rocking the jaw.
He fends off the attack.
Nicely done. Snap suplex. So quick.
God, the starving impact.
Oh, the sledgehammer connects. That'll scramble your insides.
Umaga was ready there.
One reversal after another. These two are reading each other's minds.
Each competitor showing they've done their homework.
Good Lord, exerting his dominance.
Oh,
outright presentation of power then.
Camel clutch. Great way to break it. He's a projectile now. Coming back into the ring, back to the action. Counter from Umaga. Pulled in from belly to belly. He's got him scouted.
Bam!
Reversals, reversals, and more reversals.
With an uppercut. Unfortunate uppercut.
Umaga's putting something together.
He got it right through the wall.
My God. I assure you, that did not feel good, Michael.
No kidding.
Great observation, Doctor.
Oh, stiff uppercut.
Guys, they're getting way too close for comfort here.
Yeah, I've seen this before, and it doesn't end well.
The game getting picked apart here.
The game needs to pull a trick from his sleeve.
What a battle we are witnessing.
We're at a stage where someone's going to have to shift it into another gear.
And now he's making his way up the side of the cell.
Safety clearly isn't a concern for him right now.
How can it be in this type of match? Heart-pounding, adrenaline pulsing, and that's just...
Okay, he is not going to let him make a mockery of things.
Oh.
This entire arena... edge of their seats watching these two clash on top of the cell.
Saxton, I don't think they're completely aware of their surroundings. They just have tunnel vision for each other.
Mistake by Umaga. Step suplex.
Very nice.
Someone get the EMTs ready. I just know this isn't going to end well.
Precariously battling 25 feet up in the air.
Really just laying it in.
Oh, no. Stop right there.
They got up there, but how are they going to get down?
I don't know if they thought that far ahead.
Caught all that with his face, and now Umaga is bleeding good.
Uh-oh. With the reversal.
Uh-oh. Reversal from the game. Solid punch.
Guys, we know just how dangerous Hell in a Cell can be, and we're seeing it up close right now.
Oh, nothing good ever comes from fucking on top of this.
Uh-oh.
Oh, can you do it in the cross face?
I'm going to tap out here, but it ain't going to matter.
You still do a lot of damage. And rolls him off.
Close line.
So effective. Hell of a mountain, gentlemen, and these poor souls are duking it out at the summit.
Face full of turnbuckle. as we all know, Hell in a Cell matches tend to deteriorate once the competitors leave the confines of the ring. He climbs into the ring.
Triple H, the Cerebral Assassin.
Abdominal stretch. It's locked in.
This is a great way to wear down your opponent.
Oh, no, this is not where he wants to be.
He better think of a quick counter. He's going to tap out.
Oh, wait a minute. There it is.
That's a counter with style.
Not the position you want to be in right now. Right by those cell walls. He'll head to the ring.
The ledge has him set. Pedigree. Looks like the champ is going to retake.
Uh-oh. Oh, look at this. Locked in. Submission move here.
He's got it.
And there's the tap. Ref might need to get in there to force the break.
The challenge. Ooh, he retaliates.
Dodged right on cue.
Neckbreaker.
Oh, the sledgehammer connects. That'll scramble your insides.
And there's more damage mounted.
Both arms.
And Triple H well scouted. With that, he picks up a late fall. Oh, the physicality on display there. Unbelievable. He's reaching under the ring for anything useful.
He grabbed the chair. Now would be a good time to run.
Caught in a bad position here. Snake eyes. The champ's taking an immense amount of damage.
This is a great way to wear down your opponent.
I think he's got it locked in good. I just don't know how to counter this thing.
I don't want to see him tap out. Not like this.
He's risking permanent damage.
Abdominal stretch.
Fighting out of
That's
it.
That's one way to get out of it.
Nice.
Fishing for something beneath the ring.
Grabbing a bat, and here I am without any peanuts.
Ripped in the hard way.
And Umaga is in control.
Umaga is determined right now.
And an impactful display of offense we just witnessed there. And that was a precisely measured attack. And he barely evades. More attacks to the neck area.
Not a pretty sight to witness.
Call Hunter's secretary. Tell him we found the hammer.
Winding it up. Boom! Smothered spike.
Uh-oh. Triple H with a count.
Umaga sidesteps.
Both arms hooked.
There's no escape from the camel clutch.
I have no idea how he hasn't top out.
Got it. And the champ adds to their legacy.
The devil was afoot in this Hell in a Cell match. Let's take another look, guys.
your winner, and still the WWE Champion, Triple H.
Just an unbelievable win here after everything that was thrown at them.
Talk about resilience. Talk about endurance.
Really, talk about stubbornness.